Oh my. Hello. How are you? Why, of course. It's always good to meet you. Of course. My name is Dr. Andrew Michaels. And I am here to help you. And what I am going to specifically help you with today is passing that test. We're going to get to the bottom of your doubts and fears, the issues you have. We're going to pull all of that negativity out of your mind. And you're going to pass this test. You will pass this test. I think the whole problem is we say, I don't know. I can't. I'm not sure. As I live and breathe, we are going to crack open that noggin of yours. We're going to get all of those thoughts out, those negative thoughts. There's one right there. We're going to pull every single one. Of these negative thoughts. Out of your mind. Here's a couple that fell out. I bet you didn't even know that. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. You're going to have to be very patient. We're going to have to crack open that shell. I think we're making some progress. And now that we've made some progress, let's see. What do we see there? Oh, there's a good one right there. Oh. Can you hold still? Okay. Hold on. Right. There. Now, do you see that? Look at that. Look at that. You didn't even know that was in there. All that negativity. There's plenty more where that came from. Here's some right here. See that? I bet you didn't even know that was in there. Now, there's more there, there, and there. So we're going to stay busy. It helps with a little bit of light, I can see. That one there's kind of stringy. Look at that. Look at that. I'm troubled, but I'm confident. We're going to get every one of them out. If it's the last thing I do. Here's another one. Look at that. And when we get all of these doubtful, ugly, foggy cobwebs, these horrible negative thoughts out of your mind, you are going to pass this test. You will pass this test. You are going to ace this exam. Listen to the words that I'm speaking from my voice. You will pass this test. You will ace this exam. You will succeed in this course of study. You are a good student. You put the time in. You worked hard. You worked diligently. You're very studious. I am proud of you. I am proud of you for coming this far along. Better student than I am. That's right. You're a much better student than I am, and if I could pass these kind of tests to advance my career over the course of my lifetime, you certainly can pass the same exams. You can go further in your life than me. Every generation becoming smarter and smarter, going further and further. Oh, there's a big one. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. All that fog, all that doubt. Dispose of it later. We're going to dispose of all these nasty negative thoughts, and you are going to pass this test. You will pass this test. I say it over and over because it's true. You're going to ace this exam. You have worked very hard, and you are going to pass this exam. You're going to get a good grade, and you're going going to go forward. Your studies will advance. You will graduate. You will become a learned individual. You will become a man among men, a woman to be reckoned with. You will succeed where many others have failed. Failure is not an option for you, because you will pass this test. Look at that. Look at it. So light, so frail, but look how dangerous it can be when you allow these kind of thoughts to enter your mind. You must not allow it. You must. Pass this test. Because we're all counting on you. And you're someone we respect for all the hard work they put in to their studies. You are someone to be reckoned with. You are someone who is awesome to know, awesome to have as a friend. You are so important. You will be someone who doesn't give up. You will be someone who succeeds. And succeed you shall, because we're going to pull every one of these negative thoughts, no matter how big or how bold they are, no matter how rotten they are, out of your mind. They have no place in your spirit. You're a child of the stars. You are made in your creator's image. Horrible, negative, foggy, terrible, destructive thoughts do not belong in your mind. And why do we keep coming back to this? Because you need this. You need the reinforcement of knowing the world has enough negativity in it without you adding to it. You need to be a positive force, an orderly force in a chaotic universe. You must bring order to the force of chaos around you. And you can. And you shall. As we clear these dusty cobwebs of negativity, these horrible, horrible negative thoughts from your mind, you will pass this test. You wouldn't believe how many we have already. It's so important that you keep going. Study hard. Study often. Manage your time well. There's plenty of time for fun and tomfoolery. Horseplay is something for children. You're not a child anymore. You're becoming an adult. We need people like you that work hard. Study hard, play hard, and live fast and strong. Excel at your trade. Excel at your crafts. Excel at your studies. You will pass this test. You will ace this exam. You will finish this course of study and move on. You will become successful in life. Very successful. And I'm proud of you. I'm very proud of you. And it bears repeating over and over and over again. Notice those thoughts in the back. They're hard to get to. That yielded so much. It was well worth the extra effort. Look at that. Look at it. Do you really need that cluttering up your mind? Look at it. Look at the damage all of that negativity was doing to you. Well, no more. No more. I put it away. Get those negative thoughts out of your mind and pass this test. Look at that. Look, on the edge, it doesn't look like much, but it's very, 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 very dangerous to have these kind of thoughts running around and inside your mind. Well, let's try this. This might work. Oh, yes. Oh, oh, look. Look at the amount. It's like Santa's beard inside your mind. We've got to get all of it out. Because you are going to pass this test. Not maybe, not I think. I know. Look at that. Look at the nebula. Look at that nebula of thoughts poisoning your mind. Do you really want that in there? No. Do you want to pass this test? Yes. Do you want to ace this exam? Yes. Do you like studying hard? Yes. Because you know that it yields results. And the results are that you finish this course of study and you move on to the next chapter in your life. In your life, the next chapter in your life, and that's where you are destined to go. That's where you are destined to be. Not stuck in neutral, not going in reverse, all five gears going forward, all five gears in synchronicity. Your mind, your body, and your... your soul in sync with each other, you will become a better person from the work you've put in to your life. And I'm proud of you. And it honors me to know you. And you are beautiful. That's right. You are a beautiful mind. You are a beautiful mind. And you have a beautiful soul. And you are in sync with your mind, body, and soul for the purposes of passing this exam. And you are going to ace this exam. You are going to pass this test. Oh, look right there. I missed a spot. I missed a little one. We want that out. You won't believe how much we have. Just take a look. Like much, but look at that. Look at all of that. All that clutter makes your thoughts foggy. Come slowly, because you have to swim through the briny confusion, the tangly webs of all these negative thoughts. And then, on top of that, it makes you tongue-tied, cotton-mouthed, unable to speak fluidly, to enunciate your words properly, to mispronunciate words. It's a crime at your level. It's a crime to forget how to properly spell, to properly use grammar, because you're confused. Your mind is confused with all of that clutter, all those disparaging thoughts. Well, we're pulling all of that out, because there's nothing left inside your mind except positivity and the fact that you, my friend, are going to pass this test. You will pass this test. Any remaining fragments of negativity from your mind. Through the nose. Through the mouth. Into the nose. Out through the mouth. Join me. Fragments from your mind. They're gone. was a better Reiki master, and I could reach in and push away all of these problems for you. I wish I could remote heal you quickly and efficiently, but alas, I rely completely on the placebo effect. Hold still. Hold very, very still. While we make contact with your third eye. Slow down. And we pull you in. I am honored. I'm honored to know you. As I reach out to you, I want you to know I am honored to know you. Masters. And I see in their hearts, and I see in their hearts that which they want to pluck away from you. And how they want to pluck these things out of you. And they struggle to pluck these things from you. From the ether around your mind, that unseen dimensional space between the prime material plane and the astral plane, we pull these ethereal, negative, unwarranted, unwanted thoughts from your mind. We do it time and again, so that you will succeed in life. I want you to succeed. I pass this test. I know you will ace this exam. Your studies are solid. Your habits are good. My Reiki is powerful, but it is nothing. Nothing compared to the labors you place on the work you do. You are a person to be reckoned with. You are somebody I am proud to know. You will be successful, and you will not fail. Say it with me. I will not fail. I will not fail. And I will pass this test. You will pass this test. You will finish the study course and move on to the next chapter in your life. You will be successful. And I am proud to know you. And I want to emphasize, I am proud of you now. Not when you have that degree hanging on the wall. I am proud of you now. You have chosen to better your life. And whenever a human being makes that decision to improve their life, we should all be honored. We should all be proud. And we should all be proud now of the accomplishments that you have achieved in your mind. And in your mind, you make it a reality. You are changing your reality. You are warping reality around you in your own small way. You are taking control of your destiny. And we should all be proud of you, my friend. It's a precious gift to see someone warping reality, forcing change in their life, changing their fate, making things happen, making a thought, an idea, a reality. Your hand, with your mind, with your hand, making a thought a new reality. Think about that. Don't belittle the human experience. Don't belittle the trials and the tribulations of those sitting around you, struggling for success, struggling to succeed, passing those tests around you, acing those exams around you. You're in a brotherhood of change, a brotherhood of advancement. Forward-thinking minds for the future. And I'm proud of you. And I'm proud of you now. Because you are going to pass that test. You are going to ace that exam. And you are going to go forward in your life and be successful. And when you do, you only can say, I did this. I did this. I did this. For once in your life, own up to it. You did it. Not me. Not them. And certainly not them. You did this. You did this. You made it happen. You made a thought a new reality. And you passed that test in the past. Past tense. You passed that test. And you aced those exams, and you finished your course of study, and you went on to have a good, wonderful life. See it. Reach past your goals and pull it into you. Pull this new reality into existence. Make it happen. And I know, I only know a few of you, and you say, how can you be proud of someone you don't know? Because I do know you. In my heart, I already know you. Because we're all brothers and sisters. All of us are unique and different. But yet we are all still brothers and sisters. Do you think I didn't have the same problems you did one day way back when? I'll tell you a story before I leave you. I was struggling with a job that basically met our needs in my family. I had a wife and two children. And I got laid off, as sometimes I did, but I had worked very steady for 5 years. 5 years. I had been offered a job, but I was afraid to take it. I wasn't confident in my skills, and I would have to pass a test. I would have to get a license to hold that job. So I was out of school for quite a while, maybe 10 years, and there was a lot of trepidation and fear. And my heart and my mind weren't in sync with this. But getting laid off and sitting there looking at somebody else asking them, well, what am I going to do in my mind? What am I going to do? And then having them go, well, what are you going to do? And I went, I'm not giving him that. I'm not going to beg him for a job. No, I'm out of here. No, I'm this is it. I'm moving forward now. I'm not taking this anymore. And I walked out of there with my last paycheck. In those days, they handed you your last check. I don't know if they still do. I sat there and I held that envelope in my hand and I started my car, and I thought, if I drive around the front of this building and I ask them to put me to work here and I try to, you know, quit this job and try something new, it's a risk. And you know, you think about that wife and kids back home counting on you. You have to bring that check home. And I said, well, that's true, but right now this is the last check, unless something changes. So if there's a time to do it, this is the time to do it. And I not so much prayed, because it wasn't a prayer. As crazy as it sounds, I just talked to God, my creator, whatever he is, whatever it is for anyone. For that me that day, I said, I'm not doing this anymore. I'm not working this hard for this amount of money, and we're never going to get by. We're never going to get ahead. We're just scraping and scraping every payday to payday. There's got to be a better life for me, and there's got to be a better life for her and those kids. And I leave out a few things. I finally put the money together to buy a house. I buy a house and my boss lays me off. Yeah, it wasn't his fault, but nobody was trying too hard to put me to work. I think it was their own chance for a little giggle. Oh, you got yourself a house now. Well. Now, with a house note on the line, a wife and two kids, I said, Lord, if you lead me out of Egypt, this is exactly what I said. I'm not making this up. And I'm not saying I felt divinity. I'm not saying I felt the hand of God on me, because I didn't. But I had something else. I had the heart and resolve to make a change in my life. And I said, and this is exactly what I said, Lord, if you lead me out of Egypt, I'll never complain again. If you lead me out of Egypt, I'll never complain again. Now we both know that was a lie. I complained a lot since then. That was 20 years ago. But I drove around front, and I went in and said, I want to work here. I'll pass that test. I'll pass the exam. I'll get my license. I'll work any job you give me. And I started at the bottom. And I worked my way right up to basically the top job that I could work there. And 13 years later, I was hoping to get 2 or 3 years out of the job. 13 years later, they closed the plant. It had become unsustainable to keep it open. And I got a severance and all that, and I went on to the next job. And that's another story. But here was a kid hoping he'd get 3 years of work. And 13 years later, I walked out of there with my head up. I was happy. I signed my paperwork and I walked right out. And I swear with my hand to God, in 13 years at that place and all the benefits and all the income I had, I never looked over my shoulder. I got in my car, started my car, and I drove right out. Because life is about change, and life is about a continuing adventure. And whatever was back there was gone. I got blessed. I worked hard. And I wasn't complaining when I lost that job. No. So in a way, I kept that part of my covenant. But I got in my car and I said, you know, it's going to be a new adventure and I'm going to have a good time. And you know what I did? It took a couple months. I remodeled a lot of my house in the meantime, enjoyed myself, booked and planned a trip to Disney World. Who does that when they're laid off? I want to know who books a trip for his family of five and two friends to go along to Disney when they're laid off from a job. I did, because I was confident that I would get the next job, and I did. Because you have to have faith. And if I can't have faith in me, nobody else is going to help me. And I did pass those exams. I did pass all of those tests. And I did keep going forward. And I did improve my life. And it's not bragging. It's telling you because I was where you are now. Someday you need to be where I am now. and better. Someday you need to come back and say, hey, old man, here's where I'm at now. And I'm going to say, you're doing better than me, because that's what I want to hear. I want to hear that you are doing better than me. I want to hear that. I want to know that. All right? If I could do it, you can do it. And that's how it works. Maybe nobody's ever told you that before, but if I could do it, you certainly can do it, because I actually think you're better than me. I think you have more opportunity than me, more chances than me. And I want you to be successful. And I've said it, and I'll say it again. I am here to help you. Okay? All right. Well, you take care, and I'll see you soon. And until I do, please have a most blessed day. And pass that test. Bye-bye.